morning. I'm sorry, I didn't hear people say good morning.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
This is the Senate Standing Committee on Education. We are Tuesday, April 30th, 10 a.m. Pleased to welcome our ranking members, Senator Little, also Senator Serrano, Senator Addabbo, Senator Brooks, Senator Jackson. Welcome all for being here. We have a fairly brief agenda. The first bill, S-1633, by Senator Skoufis, we're laying aside for today at the request of the sponsor, so we will move on to the next bill. S-2890 by Senator Salazar.
An act to amend Chapter 670 of the laws of 2007, amending the education law relating to directing the Commissioner of Education to promulgate regulations limiting the engines of school vehicles to remain idling while parked or standing on school grounds in relation to the effectiveness thereof. Any questions?
No, this does allow, though, for freezing temperatures and cold weather and all of that where you have to do it. I mean, we have diesel school buses that...
This is just a five-year extension of the current law.
Right, and it's necessary, and they do accommodate weather. Okay.
Move the bill.
Move the bill. Senator Addabbo.
Senator Brooks, second.
Senator Brooks.
Table,
second. Morning, Senator Lanza. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, the bill is moved. The next is S-3335 by Senator Kaminsky.
An act to amend the education law in relation to requiring non-public and private elementary and secondary schools to apply to the Commissioner of Education for criminal history record checks on prospective employees.
Any questions?
Is this a new mandate? I mean, they do background checks on, but is there... It appears that this is a required now.
Okay, you can answer. Oh, yes, it's permissive now, Senator, so this would require for prospective employees.
Can they hire them while they're waiting or no?
What's the answer to that?
No.
Do they have conditional approval?
Under current law, SED can issue conditional approval. So they would... They would still be, you know...
It could be hired.
They could be hired.
And given the outcome of the check condition.
And do they have access to fingerprints that have already been taken if they were teachers in other schools and all of that?
If it's run through the state education department, yes. If it's run by another agency, no. We can't share that information agency to agency.
So if they had been in another public school where they had already been fingerprinted, they'll
have been in another school, yeah.
They'd be on file.
Any other questions?
Bill.
Thank you, Senator Addabbo. Bill, second.
Second.
Thank you, Senator Jackson. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
I'm without rec.
Okay.
Thank you.
And the bill is referred to finance. The next is S-4008B by myself, Senator Mann.
An act to amend the education law in relation to encouraging schools serving grades 9 through 12 to have student governance if feasible.
Yes, comment.
I think obviously that's, I think it's not happening. It's a great way to get our children engaged in civic engagement, and from the government point of view, we depend on them to be our leaders of our country down the road. So this is a good thing, and I support it wholeheartedly.
Thank you, Senator Jackson. How would you? I did an informal survey in my district and found that while there are many school districts that do have these kinds of clubs, this encourages it. This is an opportunity for children who want to have leadership positions or find out about it to participate. And obviously, we did not make it mandatory. It has, if feasible, and obviously, we're ready to work with anyone who needs a greater flexibility.
I'm surprised, actually, that most of my schools do have it, but they're not as large.
Yes, I think
schools you represent.
I think smaller and particularly non-urban districts may have it, but in districts that have multiple schools within a district, it's not across the board.
It might be good to just provide a model.
That's a good
organization,
idea.
How to go about it.
That's a good idea too.
I'll move the bill.
Senator Little, move the bill.
Second.
Senator Brooks, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, next is S-5184.
An act to amend the education law in relation to military voters and ballots for election of members of the Board of Education and School District Public Library Trustees, and the adoption of the annual budget and School District Public Library budget and referendum.
Any questions? Okay.
Second.
Senator Brooks, Senator Dago, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, the bill is moved. The last is S-5192.
An act to amend the education law in relation to interim rates to reimburse special education schools.
Any questions? This bill would really help our special schools have more up-to-date rates for reimbursement. It's been a longstanding problem that we haven't addressed.
Yeah, I'll move the bill. Very good.
Thank you, Senator Little. Senator Jackson, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Bill is referred to finance. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for the productive meeting.